Ali here from Sports Templates, and today I'm going to show you guys how to use the Sports Fabrics logo mockup pack. So by the end of this tutorial, you'll be able to create stunning and realistic logo mockups like the ones we're seeing right now. So why should you use a logo mockup, you might ask? Well, I'm glad you asked, because I already have three different scenarios where a logo mockup would come in real handy. The first reason would be to elevate your logo design and present it in a realistic and tangible way. This will help you sell your logo idea better by letting your client envision how the logo would look like when applied as a patch or on a jersey. The second reason would be to stop people from stealing your logo design. If you post your logo on a plain white background on the internet, nothing will stop some designers from tracing your logo, modifying it a bit, then reposting it as their own original work. Presenting your logo in a mockup changes the perspective and adds texture and details, which makes it almost impossible to trace your logo back to its original 2D look. And finally, the third reason you could use these mockups is to offer close shots along with your uniform concept designs. Especially if you use one of our uniform templates, it would be super easy to match the lighting and general look along with this logo mockup pack. And in this logo mockup pack, you can find three different mockups. The first one is this synthetic jersey mesh logo mockup. The second one is this honeycomb mesh logo mockup. And the third one is a jersey back logo mockup, which is basically taking a shot of the back of the jersey where the name usually goes, with the slight folds to make it look realistic, which features a 2-to-3 ratio, which works perfect for Instagram posts or as a mobile phone wallpaper, but also can work for print because it's in 5K resolution. If we zoom in, we can see the level of details and how this would look when printed on a bigger size. All right, so this is gonna be one of those super fast tutorials because it's basically just replacing the logos. So I wanna start with this one and add the NFL logo. It's as easy as going to add logo here, double click.
Then we'll open up this NFL logo from this library here, and you can find its link in the description below. So you can add it to your Photoshop and work along with me.
And just drag it into our smart object. Let's put it right here. Hide the placeholder logo, then Control S to save. It takes 30 seconds to get this done. And now you have this realistic look with the logo looking as a patch on top of the jersey. But if you want the logo to be on the actual jersey, you can just hide this logo folder and then go turn on this layer, drag the logo again, bring it on top of the grid. Let's put it something like here, hide the grid, then Control S to save, and now it looks like it's screen printed on the jersey. And you can zoom in to see the level of details on this mockup. One thing you can do to add to realism, you can go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and then just make it a little bit blurry. Usually this is how ink behaves when printed on fabric, so adding a little bit of blur might make it look a little bit realistic as opposed to these super sharp edges that you get from the logo being normal. So you can just add it in and find the perfect blur for your logo. For this one, I don't want to go too blurry, but maybe something like 0.7 just to make it blend a little bit better. Moving on to the honeycomb one, I want to add the NBA logo. It's basically the same thing. This template comes with an editable text, so you can double click on here and just add your number. This template is using a free font called Soccer League, which I've downloaded for free from thefont.com. You can find the link in the description below. After changing the font, I can just click Control S to save, and you can see how it updated the number. But for here, I want to add the NBA logo, so I can just drag it into it, and I've added these two lines, if you can see these guides, this one and this one. So I try to keep the logo between these two lines so it wouldn't go too much over the folds and it's kind of ruin how the logo looks. So you just click Control S and go back to see it, and you can see how the logo was applied on top of it as a mesh, and you can see how the logo was applied on top of it as a patch. And then I would change the background to
this lighter color, but you can choose, you can basically go for any color for this. And you can basically pick whatever works best for your logo. This one also supports the screen print look, so it's the same thing. Just drag the logo on top of it like this. Hide the grid, Control S to save, and now we get to see how it's gonna look if it's printed on top of the jersey. One more thing you can do is you can go back to the logo. So let's say you want to add something else to it, you can double click here, you can hide this one and maybe turn on this barcode. I just added this simple graphic just to kind of see how it's gonna look, because you can add any kind of graphic to make it look as if it's a patch on top of the jersey. So if I go back, you can see that it looks, and just adding these little details kind of adds more realism to your design. It makes it more interesting and more yours. So you can pretty much add any kind of graphics or details to make this logo mockup more interesting. And again, you can zoom in to see the level of details on these mockups. This is a 4K mockup and it's fully editable. Now, the last one is the jersey back logo mockup. And for here, if I want to do Michael Jordan's jersey, I can just double click here, go to your name. It's editable text with this curve, so you can just double click on it. Let's do Jordan. And from here, I'm going to choose the Bulls font. This is also a free font that I found online. Just wrote Chicago Bulls font, went on this website, and I found this font. Just downloaded it from here and added it to my computer. And now we have it ready. We can do the same thing to the number. Let's do 23 here. Let's bring the numbers closer together. And let's do a black color here. I usually wouldn't want to go to 100% blacklist. Usually I would go just to something kind of off black like this, and I would use the same color on the name up top. Also, if you want to add, if you want to increase this white stroke, I can just double click on the font, go to stroke and increase the number. Let's try something like 50. All right, then one last thing I want to change is placeholder NBA logo and put the Jumpman logo. So I can just double click here, drag the font on top of this one, then just hide this logo and Control S to save. And we have it ready. One last thing we can do is just change the background to red. I just noticed that this 23 is super close, so we can just go back and bring it down a little bit, maybe center it a little bit more, so something like this. Let's save again and go back. This is a flat kind of look with basic lighting, but if you want the lighting to be a little bit more harsh, you can just easily go to texture effect, then go to lighting. It's set at 29%. If we raise it, you can get this harsher light going on the jersey to make it look more interesting. I also have a top light. You can turn it on and turn it off. Maybe make it stronger like this. Don't be afraid to play with these layers. You could totally change the look and feel of your jersey. So if you want more shadows, you can just increase the shadow one. Or maybe you want more reflections, you can just go to reflections and Control J to duplicate. And now we have more lights hitting our jersey. Or you can just go totally different route and just do the dynamic lighting. And this is basically just will give you more options to change how the light goes on any place off the jersey. So you can change it from here, and then you can select the channel mixer and fine tune it to get the right amount of light you want. So you can really make this mockup 100% yours. All right. One more thing that's included in this mockup pack is a Photoshop action that I've made for you so you can add stitching to these logos. So if we hide this layer and go back to the patch, if we zoom in, we can see that it has these hard edges. And let's say we want to add some stitching to them to make them blend more. This can be done in one click. All you have to do is install the included Photoshop action and the Photoshop brush that comes with it. It only takes one click to get it done. So to do this, you can go to your downloaded files. You're going to get all your files like this. You can go to Stitching Photoshop Action. Right click on it and extract here. That's going to give us two files, Sports Templates Fabrics. This one is an action and the brush one. All you have to do is drag this file and just drop it on the top bar here in Photoshop. And then the same thing for the brush. Click and put it here. Now to double check that we actually got the brush, we can just go select the brush, click here and go all the way down. We should find it here, Sports Template Stitching. It's gonna look like this. If it didn't work, you can just import it manually. So you can just click this little icon here and import brushes. Then you select the brush file that's included. And now to make sure that we got the action, we can just go to Window, Actions, and now we're gonna see it here. Sports Templates Fabrics Action Pack, and we have three different actions for big stitches, medium stitches, and small stitches. Also, if it didn't work, you can manually add your actions here by clicking on this icon here and then load actions, and then you can just select the file that's included. So all you have to do is select the color you want the stitches to be. So let me try something kind of off-white like this, and let's try first with the big stitches. Alright, so it's done here, and we can zoom in and see how these stitches look. Now if this looks too big for our logo, we can just hide this layer and then try again with the medium one. Just gonna do something like this. Let's hide this medium and let's try with the small. And then you have three options to select from. Also, you can combine two. So for example, I can combine the medium and the small one, maybe put one on top of the other. We get some sort of an interesting look like this. We can add the big one on top, but that's probably gonna look too busy. It's up to you, but this is gonna definitely add a nicer touch to your logo. It's gonna make it look even more realistic. This action works on all three mockups. So if we go back here, let's hide this one. Let's try again. We just need to turn on the NBA logo, put it back on. And let's try with the medium one this time. And it's done. You can see all the stitching here. It's also applied on this barcode. You can look at it here. Also, we can apply it on this one. Let's try small stitches for this one. And let's do it. And you can see the details here, how the stitches is going. Let's try, I think maybe big might look nice. So let's try big as well. And just hide the medium one. So big is gonna look more fitting for this one because we have this big number here. So it's gonna look pretty appropriate for the size of the number. It's gonna look pretty realistic. But sometimes it might not look for small details like this. So what we can do is we can just select this area, hide it, then turn on the small one, which works with it, and then just put it under and select it like this, then select inverse and delete the rest. So we know it's only on this element. Then again, we can come in to look at these details on all of these mockups. And that was it for today. Hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and looking forward to see what you can do with it. Just before I let you guys go, I just noticed that I've been running this YouTube channel for 4 years so far and never asked anyone to subscribe. If you follow through with this tutorial until this point, I think you should just smash that subscribe button. Just trying to be like the other channels on YouTube where everyone's asking you to smash that subscribe button. But if you don't feel like it, it's all up to you. I'm not gonna shame you into doing it. Alright, well, I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and see you guys on the next one. Like right. Took everything, ain't nothing left.
Count your blessings, count your steps. At your throne like we that strap. It's way too cold under this flesh. All we need, but we don't mesh. All we need, can leave us a mess. Down all my drills, it is old news.